our body is a machine and all the cells in our machine are working very actively to run the machine. That is our body. Now, the name of the chapter is the excretory system. Now, when the machine is working so much, when each and every cell is working so much and actively producing energy, then at the same time, we also have to keep in mind that we are also producing a lot of wastes. So, how those wastes are removed from this body, that is going to be the topic of discussion of us. Now, substances which we need to get rid of from our body. Number one is, most important is nitrogenous wastes. Various types of nitrogenous wastes are there, which are produced by different living organisms. Some living organisms produce ammonia as the prime or chief excretory waste. Some organisms produce uric acid as the chief excretory wastes. But us, we human beings, produce urea as the chief excretory waste. So in the chapter excretory system, even though we excrete, we give out, we have to remove so many waste materials from our body. But in this chapter, we will see that this system is actively involved in removing the nitrogenous wastes from our body. CO2 is removed by the respiratory system. The CO2 which is produced in the cells during respiration is given out as a waste product from our respiratory system. Excess salt, NaCl, given out through the sweat. Sometimes we all have tasted our sweat. It tastes a little bit salty because of the presence of the sweat. Salt, vitamins, especially the water-soluble vitamins, vitamin B, vitamin C, these two are the water-soluble vitamins. Even if we consume a lot of vitamin C through our juices, our body cannot store it because it is water-soluble. So excess of vitamins, water-soluble vitamins B and C are also given out from our body as a waste because that is extra and we cannot use it. Water, lot of water that we consume, most of it is used in the metabolic functions and rest of it is used to, we throw it out of our body. And it helps us to take away the heat which is produced in our body. So when we produce heat in our body, water's function is to take out that heat from our body. Okay? So water is also given. Now lastly, bile. All the red blood cells or all the dead red blood cells which are processed by the liver and converted, broken down and converted into bile. So that is also one of the waste products which we need to throw out from our body. But bile is given out from our body through our digestive system. Excess CO2 is given out by our respiratory system. But the prime importance of this chapter is we will see how we get rid of the nitrogenous wastes which are produced in our body. And the nitrogenous wastes which are produced, they are given out from our body in the form of urine. So, in this chapter, we will see how the urine is produced and how we get rid of the urine from our body. Now, to study this, first our focus should be on knowing what is our excretory system made up of. What is our excretory system made up of? So, our excretory system is made up of a pair of kidneys. It is made up of a pair of kidneys. Alright? So, they are present in our abdomen, especially towards the back of our abdomen. And through the kidney arises two tube-like structures. Now, if you notice these two tube-like structures, you will see that their shape is like a funnel. Funnel means one part is broad and the other part is narrow. So you can see this part which is coming out from the kidney are broader and this part is narrow. So this narrower part is called the ureter. So there are two kidneys, there are two ureters and there is a urinary bladder. There is a urinary bladder. Now, role of kidney is to produce urine. It produces urine. It converts the waste, the nitrogenous wastes, to be excreted as an eliminatory substance, which is called urine. Function of ureter is to conduct the urine from kidney to the urinary bladder, and the urinary bladder, function of urinary bladder is to stores urine temporarily. So stores urine temporarily till the time it is ready to be thrown out of the body. Now, one thing everybody has to keep in mind, how the ureter meets the urinary bladder. The ureter comes, this suppose these are the two kidneys. So ureter comes out and then enters the urinary bladder from the back. So these two ureters enter the urinary bladder from behind of the urinary bladder, and when they enter, these dotted lines which I have drawn, that indicates that the two ureters are entering the urinary bladder. Suppose this is the urinary bladder, the two ureters are entering the urinary bladder, and the ureters inside the urinary bladder go to some distance. That means the ureters, end of the ureters are somewhat projecting. So they are entering into the urinary bladder and they are going quite deep inside the urinary bladder. So the ends of the ureter inside the urinary bladder is somewhat projecting. And due to this projection, what happens? These projected ureter inside the urinary bladder, the projected ureters act as valves. They act as valves and prevent the urine to go back into the ureter when the urinary bladder squeezes to throw the urine out. So when the urinary bladder squeezes to throw the urine out, so the urine, there is a chance that the urine can also flow back into the ureter. This does not happen. This is prevented by the projections of the ureter into the urinary bladder. So when the ureters go into the urinary bladder, what happens? The projections act like a valve which prevent the backflow of urine into the ureter. Prevents the backflow of urine from urinary bladder to ureter. Now, one more thing. The urinary bladder is lined by smooth muscles. Lined by smooth muscles. Now, these muscles are in the relaxed state. So when these muscles are relaxed, it contains the urine. And when the muscles are relaxed, there is an opening. So this opening is called urethra, through which urine comes out. And also we have to keep in mind that the opening of the urethra is guarded by another muscle, which is called sphincter. Opening of the urethra, urinary bladder into urethra, is guarded by a special muscle called sphincter muscles. Now, these sphincter muscles remain contracted. So when they are contracted, what happens? When they are contracted, urine does not flow out of the urinary bladder. Right? So it's like a tap. The tap is closed, so urine cannot flow out. Remember, when the sphincter muscles are closed, smooth muscles of urinary bladder are relaxed. Right? So urine is present here. Urine is stored temporarily. Now, when there is an impulse from the brain, there is an impulse from the brain which arouses a desire of urination. So during that time, the sphincter muscle will relax and the urinary bladder muscles will contract. So urinary bladder muscles contract, sphincter muscles relax, and the urine passes out through the opening, which is called urethra. I'm explaining once again. Under normal conditions, the urinary bladder's smooth muscles are relaxed and the guard muscle, that is the muscle which is guarding the opening of the urethra, that is called sphincter muscles, they are contracted. So when the sphincter muscles are contracted, the opening of urinary bladder into urethra is closed. Now, during the time of urination, we get this impulse of urination from our brain. Our brain gives the instruction. So during that time, the sphincter muscles, which were so long compressed or contracted, now relaxes. And the urinary bladder muscle, which was earlier relaxed, now becomes contracted. And due to the contraction of the urinary bladder muscles, the urine from the urinary bladder passes out through the opening, which is called urethra. Alright, I hope this topic, which is just about the excretory system of human beings, have been explained to you. One more thing I would like to tell you. There are some blood supplies. So how the blood is supplied to two kidneys, so that we will understand after some time. One more thing you have to keep in mind, that how does the kidney purify, produce urine? The kidney produces urine by purifying the blood. So in the later classes, we will understand how blood is brought to the kidney and how that blood is purified and how after this purification, we get urine. I hope this is clear to you.